Hi everyone, and welcome to another super exciting edition of C4. Let's meet the teams. On my left, I have Bebe. Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
Very good.
Okay.
Except I have a cold.
Oh, that's okay. Now you're a big star, aren't you?
I
was talking to Dominic, actually.
I'm very low-key.
Oh, okay. And Dominic, how are you today?
I'm very good, thanks, Rob.
Okay, well, take care. Don't get sneezed on by dear old Bebe, although I think you'd enjoy it.
I'll turn this way.
Yes, you should do. Now, on the right, hello.
Hello.
You are Stuart, aren't you?
Oh,
yes,
I knew this would happen.
Hello.
So I can hear the breeze. And you are?
Karen.
Claren.
Okay.
So it's Stuart and Claren. Okay, well, let's very quickly move on to the first montage of images. So let's take a look, please. Who is this crazy lady with no clothes?
Ooh.
I have to say, Karen got particularly excited when she saw that. What's this picture about?
Failed violinist planning a career change to porn industry.
Okay, no, let's move over to this side. Do you guys have any idea?
Do I have to hit that thing?
You do indeed, that's why it's there. Otherwise, it'd be a waste of money.
So she can play with or without clothes on.
Okay, she
can indeed.
And
that's the talent she's trying to show.
Okay, it is one of her many talents, but she appeared on a specific talent show in the UK. Dominic, you are from England. What was the talent show?
Was it called Naked Music? Did she perform a piece called Hair on a G-String?
I really regret bringing you back this week.
If you know anything about classical music, that's funny.
It is. Okay, so there's three people at the Stuttgart Institute of Music laughing.
She was on Britain's Got No Talent. No talent whatsoever.
Okay, well, Stuart's having a bit of a laugh, but it's actually called Britain's Got Talent. And she's a 29-year-old Chinese woman who appeared on this show playing the violin, but she played with clothes on during the show. But what are these naked photos all about?
Showing that she's got other talents.
Yeah.
Okay, that's well, limited talents.
Yeah, that's the thing I was wondering. Like, what is she trying to show? Because, you know, if you can play the violin really well, that's good. But you can say, I can play the violin naked. That doesn't really add to your talent.
Well, don't you play the piano?
Yes.
Have you ever played with no clothes on?
No.
That is another one of my fantasies.
I wasn't very creative about it.
Okay, well, tonight you can go home and give it a go. Would you actually, now you host a show called The Wonky Wheel, don't you? What's it called?
It's called, well, actually, I just say ATW. It's got a funny English name. Let's not mention it.
Okay, let's forget about that. but would you ever appear naked to promote your show?
No.
Really, never?
No.
Not even with two
not
little
Not even
radios.
Tastefully with
no.
a violin.
But it might work. I mean, it's working for her. We're talking about her.
Working for her.
I have to say, it seems like Dominic would pose nude to
have
promote
Have you heard
his
her
video.
Music, though, Dominic?
You'd need a cello, though, not a violin.
Yeah.
Oh.
you need a tin of Red Bull for Dominic. Okay. Well, anyway, Karen, do you play any musical instruments?
I play the guitar.
You do?
Mm-hmm.
That will actually cover most of
everything.
Oh,
wow. I never thought of that.
Yeah, you should be okay playing it naked.
But the thing is, you can have the narrow part at the top that would cover you.
Oh.
I don't know why this is an issue, because lots of Chinese stars appear naked to promote themselves.
Such as?
Well, in 2006, I think Li Bingbing was on Trends Health magazine, naked.
Have you actually done some research?
Oh,
I have done some research.
This is a miracle.
Yes.
Who else was naked?
There was a charity photo shoot, and Elva
posed
semi-naked.
Like Elva.
Yeah.
And,
he's into this thing.
He loves it.
Ame and Huang Xiaoming, who's male, by the way. So.
Obviously, you've done a lot of research into this.
Yeah, that's what you do in the office.
So
it wasn't research. It was just a... It's a pastime.
You literally have nothing else to do in the office before
actually,
the shoot today.
Actually, have you been to the automobile show?
No, I'm
recently?
Here. It's going on now, isn't it?
Yeah, they're models, like walking out almost naked.
Almost naked.
Yeah. How
naked is globes over there?
Yeah.
Okay. Why do you think they use models at the auto show then?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Why do you think? They use models at the auto
She's
show.
She's apologising.
Are you saying women are not good drivers?
No, I'm just saying why would you sell a Skoda Octavia with a naked woman?
Okay, could I just say, we've got a little bit off topic. We're supposed to be talking about this 29-year-old Chinese woman who posed naked with a violin. Unbelievable. But, oh, can I just talk to Dominic?
Sure.
Okay, it's okay. We'll get back to Miss Wonky Wheel in a minute. Now, Dominic, you actually went to cover a violin show recently, didn't you?
I did. I went to the Yehudi Menuhin International Violin Competition in Beijing, and I found everybody was wearing clothes.
What a disappointment!
Were you expecting naked children?
I felt very shortchanged.
Okay, well, I think... Okay, well, let's not talk about why Dominic came to China then. Okay, let's very quickly move on from illegal activities involving naked children to the next story, please. Oh, Stu is particularly moved by these images of my colleagues. What is going on here, Stuart?
This is someone's dinner.
It is someone's dinner. Do you know where these dogs were travelling from and to?
I don't know, is it northeast China?
They were actually traveling from Sichuan, 505 dogs, all the way to Guangxi Autonomous Region. And they were destined for some restaurants there. Beibei, have you ever eaten a dog?
Not that I know of.
Okay, so you could have eaten one by accident.
But I wouldn't if I knew.
If I took you on a date and I gave you a dog, what would you do?
A live one or a dead one?
A live one. Okay. It's like in Japan when they give you live fish.
As a pet?
As dinner. We're going to dinner. Obviously, Beibei doesn't get the idea of a date, so let's forget that.
Beibei doesn't get the idea of dinner with you.
It's like double shock.
Well, you've got no chance.
Why would I be going to dinner with Rob?
Okay, well, anyway, let's move quickly on to Mr. Swire. Dominic, have you eaten a dog?
I've been offered dog, but I haven't eaten one because I don't eat meat.
That is true, but you eat fish, don't you?
I eat fish.
Because you don't like them.
Because I'm pescatarian.
You are indeed. That means he eats fish. It's not a silly word. So Dominic, can you tell us, being a man from England, what English people think of eating dogs?
Generally, we don't like it, I think it's fair to say, because they're furry and cuddly. Mm-hmm. But then again, so are lambs, and we eat those.
Well, you don't, do you?
Pescatarian. I don't.
But Beibei, maybe you could highlight or answer a little contradiction for me. Because in China, you often see people eating at hot pot restaurants eating dogs. But then on the other hand, you walk down the street and you see dogs with like their little booties on, like laced up, and they're wearing little berets and stuff, and people carrying them around. Mm. How can that contradiction exist in Chinese society? Hold on, time to learn something. Beibei.
I guess people just think differently and feel differently about certain things.
Some of them consider them as pets, some of them think of them as animals and food. Okay.
Maybe it's a cultural thing, because like where I used to live in China, like I don't think people would think of eating dogs.
You're from Wuhan, aren't you?
Yeah, so it's like middle or southern part.
But do you know who else is from Wuhan? Dominic, yes, that's right. Dominic is from Wuhan. No,
he looks
actually
just like me.
You could be brother and sister.
I know.
Clones. Yeah. But in fact, except for the beard. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, but anyway, but I heard that people live in northeastern part of China. Mm-hmm. They're used to eating dogs. So it's almost like a tradition. They would eat that in the wintertime.
Really?
Okay, well, we've certainly learned something.
And Guangzhou, right?
Guangzhou. Yeah.
They eat snakes, monkeys, anything, birds.
I've had snakes before.
Have you? So you would happily eat a snake, but not a dog?
I was little. But snakes are...
You were force-fed a snake. What
it
a brutal
tastes like
family
chicken.
Environment. What does?
Snakes.
Apparently people taste like chicken as well. I learned that from that film Alive with John Malkovich.
Can I just say,
have you eaten people, Dominic?
Well, pretty sure I haven't.
Okay, pretty sure, not totally
well,
sure.
Well, you know, live in China, you're not exactly sure, but...
Could I clarify for our audience that Mr. Racism will never be allowed on the show again?
We don't
anyway,
eat people
carry
in China.
On, Fiora.
And on top of that, I just want to say that this is a story that was printed in the Daily Mail, and I'm still not exactly sure if I dislike the paper or its readers more. No offence, Rob. But in a small
Dominic
box...
Dominic doesn't like me. Okay.
Small box on the website had some additional information, and it listed 11 countries that still eat dog. What do you mean still eat dog? As if not eating dog is some kind of progress towards civilization. And then it lists the countries and shows how historic and traditional dog is to these countries. Who gives the Daily Mail the right to say this?
Do you not know that the Daily Mail only prints what everyone's thinking?
I feel like I'm sitting through some really tedious lecture now. Can we just move on to Stuart? Because I want to know, would you be an activist and jump in front of a truck carrying 505 dogs?
I would feel very sad if I saw the truck, but
would
I don't think...
Would you launch your partner Karen in front of the truck?
Oh, God.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. And
sorry,
how would you,
Karen.
You've been very quiet so far. How would you feel about being launched?
I... What?
Die for a purpose.
I was talking about dogs, anyway.
Okay. Live for nothing or die for something. That's Rambo 4. Anyway, let's quickly move on to our next story, please. Okay, anyone? And that is Mr. Swire. Dominic Swire has buzzed in to talk about violence. Dominic, what is going on in this video?
Before answering this, I'd like to clarify how many points we get for the correct answer.
Hitting the ring?
To be honest, Beibei, being the biggest star on this show as presenter of the Wonky Wheel, has already officially won the award. So, you know.
Really?
Yeah, no one else is going to get it, so you get no points. But getting it right brings you a certain degree of honour.
Something to do with taking money from a bank.
Okay, again, another reason why you had to leave England. This team.
This guy who stabbed someone else is just irate because he's been charged too much for his withdrawal. And his anger just spilled over and he stabbed someone.
Okay, well, look at Karen.
I'm sorry, like ATM, this is one of the very few places that you can get personal space in China.
Okay.
And now, not even in
not now.
Not now.
No. Now when you go to the ATM, you get knifed in the back. Does anyone know why the one guy was knifing the other guy? Bebe?
I think he kind
of... You don't have to put your hand up, we're not in school. You don't have to buzz it, because I actually asked you. Okay, do you know why the one guy knifed the other guy?
I think he must have cut the line.
Cut the line, okay. That would be clever if you meant it as a pun. So what happened with the girlfriend?
The girlfriend?
Yes.
The girlfriend?
Oh.
There was a girlfriend involved.
Oh, is there?
Yeah.
Okay.
I sent them the stories! Okay, come on, Stuart, just repeat it verbatim.
So, let's say he cut in front of the girlfriend then.
Okay, what happened was there was a girl queuing up to take money out of the ATM in Zhejiang province, and then a guy sneaked in front of her when she opened the door and took money out instead. So the boyfriend of the girl got a bit irate, jumped over the partition, and stabbed the queue jumper in the back. Do you think that's justice, Dominic?
No. I think he's a bit much of the guy with the knife.
It's criminal, in fact.
Yeah, precisely.
It's not justice at all.
There's a difference between law and justice.
It seems like on the surface that, her boyfriend is really brave. He's able
bravely
to stand up to
bravely
him.
Stabbing someone
yeah,
in the back.
But yeah. Who will want a boyfriend like that? What if you make him mad? He could do anything.
He could stab you in the front.
Yeah, so don't date anybody who would stab other people.
C4 used to be about the news, but now it's about relationships.
That's a general rule of thumb. Don't date anyone that would stab somebody else.
You've made a mistake. Okay, Dominic.
I read some comments about this on the internet, and many people suggested that the girl was just too slow, and she should be faster if she lives in China.
Okay, I think that is quite true. If you live in China, you should hurry up. But what would you do, Dominic, if your lovely girlfriend was pushed in front of in the queue at the ATM? Would you take out a machete and like take off someone's arm?
I would not, but I was thinking I wouldn't mind a guy like this to protect me from being pushed in front of.
You heard it here first. Dominic's coming out of the closet. Oh. Okay.
But also, I'm interested in the security guard. Why is he so calm? Well, first of all, he's the smallest person in the room, and he's so calm.
This is filmed outside.
Oh, is it?
Maybe you answered your own question.
But he's right there.
He's not. He's like, you calm
down
now.
Have you ever seen a Chinese security guard actually doing their job, though?
Good question.
And also, in China, I have to say, most security guards look like they're 12 years old. And they're wearing their daddy's uniform.
They're not,
though. They're pretty sickly. They look at least pretty sickly. I always wonder.
Pretty sickly?
Yeah, like
skinny.
Could
you take a security guard?
Could I take a security guard?
I meant physically, not sexually.
Yeah.
She's blushing now. we've made her shy. Wonky wheel. Okay. Stuart, have you ever had need to protect your girlfriend like this? I heard that you actually got pushed in front of in a train station.
Yeah, over a period of half an hour, I got pushed in front of, and because I'm British, I let it go, but I just got annoyed. In my heart, I got annoyed.
I bet in your mind,
let them do
you
it.
Were creating revenge fantasies.
And then I got to the kiosk, and it was the wrong place to buy tickets.
Unbelievable.
The pushing for nothing.
Exactly.
No, I didn't push. I was just waiting.
Well, he was pushed. Pushed to the edge.
Can I just say, if you look closely, was the heroic boyfriend protecting girlfriend carrying a handbag?
What, the boyfriend?
Yeah.
He was carrying her handbag,
was,
wasn't he?
Was. That's a trait.
That's normal in China.
Okay, well, that's why you haven't got a Chinese girlfriend. Anyway, let's quickly move on to the next story. Video, please. What is this lovely building? Anyone want to buzz in? It's my apartment. Okay, Bebe's buzzed in. What's going on here? What is it?
It looks like a dam hotel. And I mean D-A-M.
Okay, we couldn't have Bebe being rude.
It's not a dam. Okay. It's a quarry.
It's a quarry.
A disused quarry.
Okay, and where is it?
It's outside Shanghai, I think.
It is indeed, 30 miles outside Shanghai. This is actually a luxury so-called ground scraper resort with 16 floors below the surface of the earth. Does anyone know how much this is costing?
I'll take a guess at $555 million.
Now that man is almost clairvoyant. You know, you're the kind of person who will get pushed in front of in a queue.
I know. Where's that go? Where's that go?
Okay, well, it's actually, Stuart is actually...
Sorry.
He hasn't even got a knife, he's gone mental. But this hotel is indeed costing $555 million and it should be ready when, Stuart?
2015?
Late 2014 or early 2015. How much per room per night, Dominic? Starting at?
Is it $360?
No. It's 320.
That is right. I actually thought that you were going to give Dominic a slap in the face then when he got it wrong.
Or stab him.
Wait, is it it's 320 for a standard room? Or how do they advertise? It's like, would you like to stay in the penthouse on the ground floor? Seriously.
Okay, yeah. That is
you know?
Would you like to live underground?
Me personally.
But I hear the penthouse suite does have quite a large rooftop garden.
Or just a garden.
Yeah.
I don't know what to say now.
I do. This has got 60-meter glass curtain.
You should be hosting the show, yeah. Stu. You're really good.
It's supposed to look like a waterfall. That's the main feature of this hotel.
But wouldn't it break very easily, a glass curtain?
If you, yeah, but
if some kid throws a brick,
I don't
at it.
Think they're getting riffraff at this place for $320 a night.
The riffraff are building it.
What do you mean by glass curtain? Do you mean the windows?
It's a glass, like, yeah, it's a huge glass window which they're going to run water down, which will look like it will simulate a
waterfall.
It's basically just a sheet of glass.
It's happening in the middle of the building, though.
What do you mean in the middle of the building?
Well, in the middle of the building on the picture of the face of the building.
Oh, like the waterfall.
You see like a glass waterfall that kind of looks like it might be that curtain thing you were talking about before.
Okay, I'm frankly bored of this curtain talk, so let's move on. The name of the hotel, for those who are interested, is the Intercontinental Shimao Shanghai Wonderland. So look it up online. And actually, the whole concept of living below ground reminded me of the third Hunger Games book, Mockingjay, where District 13 has gone underground after being defeated by the capital.
Haven't.
Not a very good book. You haven't read it. It's a book for girls. Have you read this?
Never heard
of
it.
Can you read? You've never heard of it?
Mm. Not my type of book.
You should be on the one wheel. Okay, Dominic, are you going to be staying in this hotel when it opens?
I'm interested, but I'm just worried. If there's a fire, what happens? Normally you run down the fire escape. Here you're going to run up. You're going to have a lot of energy to get up the stairs if there's a problem.
Well, true. Safety issues brought up by Dominic, the voice of reason. Bebe wanted to say something, so...
Yes. So I'm not so much worried about fire because there's so much water around, mm-hmm. but anything else, like earthquake or things like that, usually we have to run outside, like to the lobby outside, but then there's water. And then if you have to go outside, would you have to go to the penthouse or
everybody take an elevator? Well, you would feel it first if it's an earthquake, I guess.
I would rather stay.
It's like having a geologist on the show.
And what if you're in the penthouse and there was a fire? Everyone's going to invade your house. It's going to be very...
Okay, well, it doesn't matter you would if be it helps out. People to live, Dominic.
I would rather stay in that huge hotel in the village in
is that the little village that has one-story houses and then the biggest,
and then the biggest hotel
on
in the world? Yeah.
Yes, unbelievable indeed. Well, we'll send you there on a CRI trip, excellent. Which you'll be paying for yourself. Oh. Anyway, it's pretty much time to wrap up now because, frankly, I've had enough. But since Bebe the big star was here today,
what?
I would like to give her the award. Let me just go under the table. This is actually an award that I stole from her office, so I'm
That's
just giving it back
similar.
To its owner. Here it is from Saft. Oh. So hold on, just calm down.
It's her award.
Anyway. It's hers anyway. So this is for you, Bebe.
Don't stab me with it.
Oh, I'm not Dominic. There you go.
Thank you.
Show it off to the audience. There you
Thank
go.
Thank you.
Wow. Okay, well, don't forget that our show, C4, I nearly forgot the name of the show then. Our show, C4, is available on the CRIEnglish.com website, but also on Weibo. Check it out down below. And don't forget to contact us by email if you have some positive comments. Anyway, that's just about it. You guys had fun?
Yes.
Okay, you really had fun, Dominic.
Absolutely.
Okay, let's go over here. And did you guys have fun, Stuart?
As always.
Karen?
Plenty.
Yeah, you look like you had fun. Anyway, I think that's just about it for now. So we'll see you next week. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Okay. Bye-bye.